I've always had a desire to create things. Since my earliest days, art and music have been my two major outlets for this energy. I'm now in Art 4, and have played the saxophone for the greater part of 8 years. Just a few months back, I got off my unhealthy addiction to wearing togas, and last summer, I made a documentary on the history of Portland jazz. While doing that, I met this guy. This guy. This guy. This guy. And this guy. The most colorful moments in my film were when they told their amazing stories.
I was the only Portland policeman ever to arrest Jim Elkins.
Stories that I didn't want to see forgotten. So, for my senior show, I set out to illustrate a handful of them. This is a step-by-step artistic process for painting 3, The Wine Song.
I guess I'm glad that they touched my life, because I never did. Drugs never was in my bag, man. You know, I drank a lot of wine, I used to. Something that I could control, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And we had a little tune that we put together. We sit in his truck and drink wine on the breaks, you know? Mm-hmm. And we put together a little tune. Wine, wine, Loganberry. Wine, wine, port and cherry, you know?
To start, I had to pick a canvas size. This 18 by 24 inch canvas would allow me to paint a much larger and more detailed image than I would ever be able to paint on a 9 by 12. However, it requires less time and paint than this 36 by 48. Since my paintings don't rely heavily on precision, I don't bother precise sketching. The important part is just to get the main lines and shapes drawn on the canvas.
Well, shall we? Tomorrow I'm gonna take this into school. I'm gonna slather a few coats of paint on this thing. Well, see you then.
Day 2, which follows the sketching day, I refer to as slathering day. After applying a coat of underpainting with a rag or paper towel, I then proceed to slather paint on and think about the consequences afterward. Again, I'm blocking in the main shapes and lines. On day 3, I face the challenge of transition. Basically, I need to make it look good. Little by little, I'll add in more details, like the fins, headlights, and grille of this car. If no significant progress is made on day 3, it is very easy to lose artistic momentum on the piece.
Fixing up some more detail. Slathering more paint on. Basically, I have no idea what the day is going to hold, so I'll just get started.
So, here's day 5 on this. It's day 5, and I'm back in the art room. It's detail time. Time to work on suits, bottles, and faces. I'm aware that this guy really does not look that much like this guy, but that's the glory of a more impressionist style. People are willing to accept looser details. For example, let's take the poster that is on the brick wall. It appears to have words on it, but truly, it doesn't say a thing.
It's day 6.
At this stage, I just have to tie up loose ends and work it till it seems right. One loose end is a lack of contrast between the car and the back wall. To solve that, I'm going to put a green glaze on the wall. Glaze is paint medium without any pigment. Because green is the complementary color of red, it helps to subtly move it backward. It would seem the only thing left to do is sign it. So if you've ever wanted to know how to paint three guys getting wasted in a car, I just showed you. I hope you feel enlightened.